Hello, once again. It is Monday afternoon as I'm recording this. We got some recruitment to talk about. First up, we got a commitment today from Cade McIntyre, 6'4", 205-pound athlete out of Nebraska. Archbishop Bergen, I hope I pronounced that correctly, just committed today. Three-star athlete, but might get that four-star bump before the end of everything's said and done, before he signs on the dotted line. So good news there, like a potential tight end for Oklahoma and Jeff Lebby's offense, obviously going for, you know, Lebby loves to use those tight ends. So I love that we're loaded up on guys with a lot of potential. So good, awesome news there. So hopefully this will add a little bit more momentum to this upcoming recruiting class, because there's a couple names keeping an eye out right now. You know, guys like Peyton Kirtland, who's like a local Orlando kid for me, out of Dr. Phillips High School, literally goes to school right behind Universal Studios. The joke is, when they play their football games, they can hear the screams from roller coasters from like Islands of Adventure and stuff. It's pretty nuts. Like, there's like a big wall there with like a black tarp, and you can see parts of the theme park like sticking up and everything. So, yeah, it's just one of those things. So he will be committing July 23rd, Peyton Kirtland. July 23rd is the big day for him. So we got a little ways. We got a little over a month for him. Caden Green, you know, a top 30 player, a borderline five-star. The big news for him is that he was supposed to take a trip to Michigan. But according to Rivals, the Michigan guys on Twitter, they said he is no longer taking that trip. Took a trip to LSU this past weekend. Was at Oklahoma the previous weekend. So he's coming down to his final choices. He's a big monster offensive tackle out of Missouri. And I'm telling you what, like, I'm really liking our chances for both of these guys. I think offensive line recruiting is about to go through the roof for Oklahoma. And when you add two big bodies like this to help, you know, reestablish dominance, you know, Bill Beatenbow with like a fresh coat of paint, with a new coaching staff and a new outlook, I think Oklahoma's going to be good to go in the future. So, like I said, you know, July is a big recruiting month. You know, for a lot of you, it's like, yeah, we know July is a big recruiting month. But for some people, they may not know. You know, I wasn't sure how the NIL era was going to affect things, if things were going to slow down, depending on the schools and whatnot. But it sounds like guys are still wanting to make their commitments before their final senior season in high school, want to get it out of the way. So the more things change, more things stay the same. So for Oklahoma right now, I would love to have a borderline five-star offensive lineman commit next month. And also love to have a local kid here in Orlando commit to OU. He can't take Universal with him, though, unfortunately. I don't think anyone is going to have that built-in advantage. Maybe UCF, but like, they're not right by Universal. They're kind of close to where I'm at in East Orlando. Universal's down on the south side. But it is what it is. Like, July is going to be one of those things where the entire month is going to be two things. It's going to be media days, and it's going to be hopefully a lot of good news in recruiting. So hopefully, you know, we will get some of that good news. The thought process with Brent Venables is that, you know, maybe we wouldn't see too many commitments until possibly during the football season, based on guys not taking visits. But the fact that, you know, Caden Green not taking any more visits, canceling his Michigan visit, I think is a really, really good sign for Oklahoma. Now, I know some of you are going to say, he went to LSU, don't rule out LSU. And look, you have a right to, I understand how you feel. There's people wanting to bring up Jacob Phillips and all what that. I totally understand that. But Jacob Phillips was already committed to OU. That's one why that one kind of hurt a little bit. Plus, a bag was dropped. So, Caden Green hasn't committed anywhere yet. So, just one of those things. We're all got to be very, very, very patient. Caden Green, like number 34 on Rivals, Rivals 100, just right there on the cusp of potentially being a five-star, really give a boost to this recruiting class if Bill Beatenbow and Brent Venables could reel him in. So just want to drop in and talk about those few things real quick. And hopefully I should be doing a live stream. My buddy Eric Lopez will do a recap of like the softball season, talk about the national championship series, and just kind of have a feel good moment. And we'll go in a little more in depth on the big announcement of UCF, Houston, BYU, and Cincinnati all together will be joining the Big 12 in 2023, and trying to dissect a little bit more, reading the tea leaves of what this could mean for conference realignment. And, you know, where does the Big 12 go from here? Are we going to be a 14-team league for a couple years, or does this open the door for OU and Texas to leave early? We shall wait and see. But until then, I'll see y'all tomorrow night. Boomer Sooner, and Catch y'all later.